you can write add jitters and add colors. So we can simply click on this submit. Yeah, you can see now colors have been added, and you can see here we have control, drought and salt, and here we have key. Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will tell you about an amazing AI tool, that is Rtutor.AI. So you can see its website is Rtutor.AI. So this website is totally free for research purpose. So if this website is not working on your computer, you need to make sure you are not using any VPN. So this website has potential to draw different types of illustrations and graphs from different data sets, ranging from simple statistical analysis to RNA-seq and more complicated experiments. So in this video, I will take one example of data set and I will upload and I will show you that how simply this website can be used to draw different types of graph. So here is one simple example. So you can see here we have column A. You can see in the column A we have control, 20 replications of control, and similarly 20 values of salt and 20 values of drought. So here we have root length data and shoot length data. So we can go back and upload this file to this Rtutor.AI. So we can select this file and we can, yeah, here it will ask you to verify your data, and you need to select different data types. And here you can see, because we have actually the treatments, and as we know, the treatments will be our factor, our treatment. So the next two, root length and shoot length, are actually the numeric number, so we can leave them as such. And now we can try by clicking on this dismiss. So you can see it has uploaded that default data set, which is also known as the data frame. So the first value we can start by writing print df. Df means data frame. So when you will write this print data frame, so it will show you your all uploaded data. So we can simply click on this submit button to check what we have uploaded. So you can see if we will print our data frame, so you can see it is showing we have uploaded control, salt, drought and alt, root length and shoot length values. So now we can go ahead and try some simple commands, like if you want to draw graphs like box plot, so you can write use ggplot2. We know that this ggplot2 is actually an R package. So actually this Rtutor.AI tool works on R, and it will create R code simultaneously while also creating HTML based file. So you can write like use ggplot2 to draw box plot. You can simply click on submit. Yeah, you can see here we have control, drought and salt, and here we have actually the box plot. So if you want to add jitters and add colors, you can write add jitters and add colors. So we can simply click on this submit. Yeah, you can see now colors have been added, and you can see here we have control, drought and salt, and here we have key. So if you want to go back to any previous step, so let me tell you, like if you don't want color and you want to go to previous step, here you can see that each time you will give a new message, so it will create a new generated chunk. So if we want to go back to chunk 2, so we can go back, and you can see in the previous step we were actually creating simple without color. So here we can go to the next step in which we have created the color. So now if you say you don't like this background, so you can write change background to white, change background to white. Yeah, you can see like this. We can simply click on submit. Yeah, you can see the background has been changed to white. And like if you want to, you can see the text font size is too small, so you can write change font size to 20 and Arial. Yeah, you can see now the size is increased. And if you want to save it, so whatever the size, like if you want to save it as an image, we can go back here and we can simply click on save. So you can see this figure is actually saved, and as here you can see actually its length is more. So if you want to adjust the width and height, so you can simply click on this. And here you can see we can adjust its size by simply adjusting the size of this window. Let me make it, yeah, like this. We can now save it as an image, and you can see in this, yeah, here you can see in this figure the size it is adjusted. So you can adjust the size by, or simply you can write the command and it will adjust the size, or you can adjust the this Chrome size. And now if you want to draw like bar plot, so you can simply click on submit. It will draw a bar plot for us. It is running the code. It is thinking little more than normal. Yeah, here one good thing, you can see it is now creating the R script side by side, so you can learn R in this way easily, and you can directly use this script in your R. So you can see now we have actually the box plot, and here you can see in the box plot, so sorry, in the bar plot we don't have actually the error bar, so we need to calculate error bar, calculate and show error bar. So it will create error bars. Yeah, you can see now we have error bars. So in this way you can play with your data, you can chat with your data, and let's suppose if there is any error, you can also ask about that error, or like if you want to interpret your results, so you can simply write here and it will generate answer to that. And now let me take you to some more complex example. So here I have wrote some questions, like we can see show me the distribution of control. So we can write here and simply click on submit. Yeah, you here you can see the distribution of shoot length for control treatment. And now we can try some different, like we can create a pie chart based on treatments. Yeah, we can go back here and submit. Be the change you wish to see in the world. Yeah, here you can see now we have pie charts of treatment ready. So if you want to save, you can simply go back and save it as an image. And now let's go back again and try to, yeah, we can plot this relationship between root and shoot. We can add trend line and we can also add the R value on the plot. So it is a little more complex. So we can go step by step, and if we want to go back to any previous step, so as I already told, we can simply go back from here, and this time we can copy this one and submit. Yeah, you can see now relationship between root and shoot length is ready. Here is root length, shoot length. So we can go a little more complex. Yeah, we can try create a violent plot of root and shoot. Create a violent plot of root and shoot. We can color by treatment and add data points. We will simply submit this. Why could not the bicycle stand up by itself? Because it was too tired. Yeah. You can see now violent plot of shoot and roots already, and similarly we can try more. We can also create a correlation map, so we can copy this and we can simply click on submit, so it will automatically create R script for this as well. Yeah, here you can see now that correlation map is ready. You can see root and shoot, it has actually high correlation, so that is why all are in blue. The last we can try is actually conduct ANOVA of log transformed root and shoot. And we can simply click on this submit. So you, here you can see the ANOVA is ready. So in this way you can also upload your file and try different graphs. So in the next video we will try to draw some complex example of data analysis and try to perform different analysis for RNA-seq data. So hopefully you like the video. If you have any question related to this video, please let me know in the comments section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.